Namaste, this is Prakash here. There is a lot that we can actually learn by looking at things which happen around us. Let me share one simple example, something that we all observe, but do we really learn from it and then utilize in our lives? If you have seen horse racing, or even the, you know, as they call the jatkas, where the horse is used to pull the cart, one thing you would have surely observed is that they have blinders. Why? Such a simple observation, but do we really use? Even when you take the power of a car, it is mentioned in terms of horsepower. It's one of the most powerful animals when it comes to running. But in case you just take off its focus, what is likely to happen? Animal experts say that horses tend to slow down or waver, look around left and right. And hence, specifically when it comes to races or running a cart, they are always run with blinders on. They just put on the side of the eyes so that the horse cannot look anywhere else other than straight, maybe at its goal. This is such a simple thing that we can also learn in our spiritual, material and professional pursuits. If you are single-minded, ekagrita, focused to the extent that other than the goal, nothing else appears. The way when Arjun was asked, what do you see in the tree, he couldn't say anything other than that the eyeball of the bird which was there. Everyone else was shooting the arrows, were seeing everything else, and hence they couldn't get the target. The same is true here. The potential for each spiritual aspirant, each human being to reach the highest potential remains in being focused. And one of the least productive ways is when your energy is channelized away from the goal. When you look at the lives of others, we all tend to compare and perish. When we look at our own material or spiritual pursuits, we look at someone else, we compare our lifestyles, our progress, our knowledge, our physical or proximity to the guru, things which go like that. And then doubts creep in. We are, of course, in a way happy when we see that somebody else is not apparently progressing as fast as we are. Even that is in some way an illusion or even a delusion of the mind. Everyone picks up his own pace, and the biggest hurdle comes when you take your focus away from the goal and look elsewhere. This is the biggest pitfall that any spiritual aspirant or anyone pursuing higher levels of material success can have, tending to look away from the goal. And when you look away from the goal, you see a lot of things and they appear dangerous in some way. And the basic nature of the human to immediately start comparing and follow prey. Oh my God, he is closer to me than, he is closer to the master than me. He is closer to success than me. And then doubts start creeping in, and then we tend to take eyes off the goal. And taking eyes off the goal is one of the most dangerous things that can happen. Imagine in a line of 9 planets which are going around the sun. If any other planet has to take the focus away from the sun, thinking that, you know, Mars is closer than me to the sun than where I am, if Pluto is going to say that, the focus gets lost and they can drift away into infinity in the space. And the only thing that keeps them closer to the goal is the focus on the primary focus, which has to be, which is the sun. The same is true for a spiritual aspirant. The goal is emergence with the master. The way Sahadev, in spite of him not being physically very close to Krishna like Arjun or Yudhishthira was, but he was supposed to have the maximum focus on Krishna, to the extent once he could even threaten Krishna that if you tend to do something which I don't want to do, I'll put you inside my heart and put you there where you can't do anything. Such was the power of his focus. You and him, you and the goal, nothing else in life. Think of Adam and Eve. they didn't have anything to compare in life, and they were apparently living happily. The same is true for us. The Guru is capable of taking as many subtle forms as is needed. 1, 1 lakh, 1 crore, doesn't matter. And they can multiply and keep one of their subtle bodies each with each of the aspirant, so that there is no need for you to compare. You are exactly fit the right dosage at the right time. Depending, of course, upon the practice that you put in, nothing comes easily and nothing comes free. Even in a free system like heartfulness, your practice is something that you still have to focus. Just because transmission is free, just because Guru's grace is free, doesn't mean that you can just keep going. You still have to toil, as they say. You have to get into the field and till the field and then plow it, and then ensure that you keep the ground fertile for the seed to germinate and become whatever it is supposed to. The fruit of the labor is always in your focus and in giving the best that you can. Like what Daji repeatedly says in many of his talks, practice like never before. In specifically situations like pandemic, in a lockdown, the time that is available to us is one of the highest. We, at least in these moments, in the last 3 months or so, and a little bit of time to come, we just cannot say that we don't have the time. That will be the biggest excuse that we can, biggest lie maybe we can tell ourselves, that I don't have the time. This is the time, and in fact he promises that 90 days is what it takes for you to reach whatever you have to reach, provided we are focused on the goal. Like the horses which runs with the blinkers on, with the blinders which ensure that it doesn't look at anything other than the goal. Stay focused on the goal. Give the best of your practice. Stop comparing yourself with anyone else's progress, knowledge, proximity or whatever, and just see the potential that unfolds in front of you in your spiritual or material pursuits. I wish you the very best in this pursuit, in going towards the goal without being distracted. Thank you.